Hello everyone. My name is Franklin Abung'ana. Welcome to my online tutorials, where I give you the insight on emerging technological issues affecting matters in education. Subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on my upcoming tutorials. Subscription is free. You won't be charged anything instead. You will be notified whenever I upload a new video. Welcome and keep on learning.
Hello guys, this is Franklin Abung'ana. Welcome to my online tutorial. Now I'm going to show you how to make timetables using a software known as aSc Timetabling software. Now these are very easy to use and a clean software among many others that we have. Now I've been using aSc for some time and you can use this software for free. If you have not installed it on your machine, just check through the description. Will find the download link. Now, making a timetable begins with planning, whereby planning refers to the subject's allocation across. Those are just a few factors that you'll consider when preparing a timetable. Now, I'll begin with a very simple timetable, that is for the lower primary, especially for the Kenyan schools under the CBC curriculum. So I'll be taking you through a process on how you can make a timetable for the grade 1, 2 and 3 respectively. From there you shall advance on how to make even more complicated timetables as time moves by. Now you need to have the time allocation for various lessons and the breaks every level. So step number one, we shall start by setting the bells. Now I'm already in the aSc timetable. You can see various icons on my window. Now you can begin to make your timetable by creating a new timetable from this point. Just click on this icon to create a new timetable, or you can, let me close this one first, or you can come to the main and then we have new there, or you can come to the files, we have new button there. So from whichever point you want to create your timetable, you can begin from there. So I'll click on new, and then step number one, you are prompted to name the school or to enter the name of the school. So I'll type there the name of the school just to personalize the software. So my school is duped BD school, and then academic year is 2021 to 2022. So step number one, you can see we have periods per day, and then we have bell times, or you rename the bells. So before you go there, we have renaming days. So I'll click so that I'll rename the days. Now what I normally change, it is the short form of the days. By default, we have two letters representing the days, but I like it when they are three. So I click on Monday, and then click on Edit, then I add N there. Should be in small letters. Add N, click OK. Click on Tuesday, click Edit, add E, then OK, repeat the same on Wednesday, and add D there, click OK. On Thursday, click Edit, add a U there, then click OK. On Friday, I'll edit, add I there, then then click OK. Click OK. So for the weekends, we have weekends on Saturday and Sunday, but we have other options there which you can select from. But for most schools, they should be the default when it comes to weekends, so that days run from Monday to Friday. That's a total of 5 days by default. And then for the lessons, we normally have 7 periods for the grade 1 up to grade 3. We normally have 7 periods in a day, and then in between we have 2 breaks. So I'll adjust this. Not really, they are already 7, so I leave it at that point, and then straight away I'll go to bell times. Now by default, these are the timings that you have. So we have the 7 lessons. Now my first lesson or period, it starts from 8 to 8:45, but for our normal bell times, it's supposed to start from 8:20 to 8:50. So I'll select the first period and then click on edit. And then the name of the period, this is how I normally name it. There I'll write period 1, period 1, abbreviation, I'll just write P1. And then for the timings, it should be from 8 to 8:20. Sorry, from 8:20 to 8:50. That is period number 1. And then I'll click on OK. So you can see I've already set my first period. I repeat the same to the second period, select, then click on edit. I'll type there period 2. Period 2, abbreviation or short form, I'll just write P2. And then for the timings, it should be 8:50 to 9:20. 8:50 to 9:20. Then click on OK. The third period, it's not a period but it should be break time. So break down, the first break time, it should start from 9:20 to 9:50. From 9:20 to 9:50. So we have a pattern here. Add break, then be printed between lessons. So you click on add break, and then the name of the break, I'll call it first break. First break. First break. I'll simply copy this and paste in this section. And then for text printout, I'll also copy the same. This one will be shown on the timetable. So I'll paste it there. And then the next thing, you select the position where you want your break to appear. So this break is before period dash. Now I already have my second period. The break should come before my third period. So from the drop down, I'll select before. Before, this break is before period number 3. I'll select that. Then the timings should be from 9:20 to 9:50. 9:50. And then I'll click on OK. Next, we have period 3. Period number 3 runs from 9:50 to 10:20. So click on edit. Then I'll type there period 3. Period 3. The short form P3. Timings 9:50 to 10:20. 9:50 to 10:20, and then click on OK. So we have period number 3. Period number 4, I'll select period number 4, click on edit and set the timings from 10:20 to 10:50. And before I do that, I'll type there period 4, short form P4, timings 10:20 to 10:50, 10:20. Click on OK. Then you have period number 5. Select period number 5. Click on edit. Period number 5, it is from 10:50 to 11:20. Period 5. Period 5. It is P5. Should be from 10:50. Click on OK. Then we have period 6. Click on edit. But before period 6, we have a second break, so I'll cancel. We have the second break. I'll click on add a break. So my second break should come before period number 6. So I'll type there second break. Second break. I'll select this and copy. I'll paste it there. We'll also paste in the timetable printout. And then this period should come before period number 6. So I'll click before period number 6. And then for the timings, break begins from 11:20 and ends at 11:40. 11:40. 11:40 is there. 11:20 to 11:40. Click OK. Next, I can set my 6th period. Click on edit. I'll type there period 6. Period 6, short form P6. So period 6, it is from 11:40 to 12:10. 11:40 to 12:10. Then click on OK. The last period, that's period number 7, it is from 12:10 to 12:40. So I'll select, then edit, type there period 7. Period 7, there we have P7. So it is from 12:10 to 12:40. Then okay. So there we have our periods already set, and each lesson takes 30 minutes. You can see the length, 10 minutes. Our first break takes 30 minutes. The second break is a short break of 20 minutes. So we have the timings already set. Now, I will close this section. We just close it and then save our timetable. Go to main, save, then save as. I'll save it on the desktop. Then I'll rename it as. Save. So see you next as we move to part 2 of my tutorial. Bye.
I hope you have learned something from this tutorial. If so, give this video a big thumbs up, comment, and share. Above all, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell on so that you don't miss out on my upcoming uploads. Thank you for watching. See you then.